Hey, this is the Swedish Guitar Nerd, and today I'm doing a rig tour with the awesome rock and roll machine that's called Frontback.
I don't know which band that is.
Okay, so here we have the modest lead guitar player.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, you can introduce yourself.
Yeah, my name is Axel, and I play guitar, lead guitar in Frontback. And I don't know if it is 7 years. Right now, but I've been in Frontback together with Andu. So yeah, that's it, I guess.
So are you one of the original members?
No, actually not. Andu is still okay. yes. Apparently. Okay.
We're changing history as we go.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I'm since the beginning.
Yeah. Okay, no. So we're here to talk gear, and where should we start with? But not with a Destroyer.
Yeah.
So what can you tell us about this one?
At first I can say that I'm a big Maiden fan. Mm-hmm. So I told myself that no, I don't want to buy any more guitars. But then this one came
you
up.
You always before. Tell yourself
yeah,
that.
Yeah, exactly. But yeah, and then I bought it directly. So I thought it would be a great live guitar and not so expensive.
No. But this is one of the newer models. It's not like from the 70s.
No. This is because I thought of buying a old one.
Okay. Yeah.
But then this new one came out.
So it
then
just came out a few years ago.
Yeah, I think 2 years ago or something. So I needed to buy it.
So what's good about it besides that it's looking fantastic?
Actually, it's very good, a good sounding guitar. Mm-hmm. Lots of body, and the pickups is Demasio. So
it's a super distortion.
Yeah,
it is like a tone sound. I don't know.
Yeah, something. I don't know if it is a super distortion, but actually one of my favorite pickups is super distortion.
Oh yeah.
So I have it in lots of my other guitars, okay. But not in this one. But at least it's it should have quite the same characteristics.
Okay.
As a super distortion.
So and I don't know. I've seen you before. You had this guitar, and I think you played on ESP Eclipse back then. Is that retired or is it still?
Actually, it's my second guitar for live, and that's my two main live guitars. So,
but that seems quite different, isn't that? Like with a Floyd Rose Tremolo and everything.
Yeah, quite big. So. It takes some time to get used to a new one without the Floyd. What to do?
Learn new tricks.
Yeah,
as you
exactly. So, but it's a very good practice as well. To change guitars and make it difficult for yourself sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. So what's behind you then? This is yours, right?
Yeah. And this is my the GCM 2000. Dual super lead 100 watts, and I bought it I think 2010, and I always uses it for live experience. So
do you use, I think you have quite a clean tone on the amp, don't you?
Yeah, exactly. I only use the clean tone in this one. And then I go for my
let's go to the floor
pedals. Yeah. So here
where does the signal come in?
The signal from the guitar is from this side here.
Yeah.
And then this is only a backup.
So is that a backup for the amp as well, or just for the pedals?
I could use it as a backup, but it through the PA, but it doesn't sound so good then.
Okay.
It should. I think it's best through a tube amp. And this is actually a boost pedal.
Yeah,
but without any distortion and
seems disengaged.
Yeah, exactly. Not used.
so this side is the backup side.
Exactly. So this is the first pedal that I use.
And what's that?
Vox. Wow.
It's a regular one.
Yeah, it's think the most common one.
Yeah.
I heard that Jimi Hendrix played at the same. And then I go through.
And then we had the magic box.
Yeah, exactly. This is actually I can. When I'm playing at home and when I'm playing, I'm recording. I usually, as I said before, I'm a big Maiden fan.
Mm-hmm.
I use a Marshall EMP.
Okay.
And I bought some pedals, distortion pedals, and didn't find the sound that I wanted. And then I heard this Raptor Folkesson distortion pedal on YouTube.
Yeah.
And yeah, it was awesome. It's a little different from the JMP, but yeah, I think it's a very great sounding distortion, it works with lots of all the amps I've tried, and yeah, I think it makes the magic as it should be.
Makes everything sound good.
Yeah, exactly.
Can you tell the viewers what who Folkesson is?
Actually, I don't have so much information about him, but I know he's a Swedish tube modifier, yeah. I think. So he's very famous in Sweden for modifying amps.
Yeah, I think it's Marshall amps. Usually.
Yeah, exactly. Always, Marshall. Yeah.
If you find a modded amp in Sweden, it's usually Folkesson.
Yeah, exactly. And I think he. So I think I heard of his name. I just checked his webpage, and then I saw that he had pedals, and then I found it on YouTube as well. And I was sold directly. So.
It sounds fantastic.
Yeah, that's good. Good, you think so as well. So at least two of us think. Yeah. Two persons.
And very Maiden-esque, if I may say.
Yeah.
So it sounds like.
Yeah, it has a very big. You can use it for like very clean distortion and to very heavy distortion like thrash metal and such as well. I think lots of it has to do with pickups and and the guitars you use as well. So.
Okay, so where do we go from the Raptor?
From the Raptor, I go to the Super Overdrive. So this is actually my boost pedal with a small. It's an overdrive, as quite logical.
Yeah. So the Raptor is on all the time when you have a distortion sound.
Exactly. Okay. So the clean sound is the amp, the lead, and everything except the solos. I only use this one.
Okay.
But for the solos, I use.
Okay, then you kick that.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, to get a boost and some more distortion.
Mm-hmm,
and
mm-hmm.
And as you see, I doesn't have the gain on max either. So if I wanted, I could have turned this up even more. Okay. But
now it's at 8.5.
Yeah, so quite a lot as well. So.
Okay, yeah. So from the Super Overdrive.
Yeah, and then this black one, go to the digital delay, a Boss as well.
There are several versions of this one. Yeah. It's like, I don't think, where are you now? Like DD9, DD7, I don't remember. So is there... There's a special reason for why you have the DD3.
No, the only reason is that I bought it when it came out. I think.
Okay.
So
that's the one was available then.
Yeah. Yeah. So these two pedals and this one have been for me since I started in Frontback, I think.
All right.
So,
and
when I bought some additional pedals and tried some else, but this is what I stuck to for live.
So when do you use the delay?
Actually, it's a little different times, but always on solos.
Okay.
But then I always try to turn it away, just so because the delay makes it more simple to play sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
So I want
it covers the mistakes.
Yeah, exactly. So I want to make it harder for myself. So I always take it away.
Okay.
Only on the solos I cheat. So that's why. And the chorus I doesn't use in Frontback so much.
Okay.
Only on like one track. Fender, I think. Yeah, and on. Actually, the whole song Remember as well. So two tracks, I think I use this one. And
so it's not something that's on all the time.
No, it's only for these two songs. And then I got the tuner, very good.
That's at the end of the chain.
Yeah, exactly. So this one goes to the amp.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it, quiet. I think.
Oh, great.
So, yeah, and I use this pedal train, very good for having lots of pedals on.
Mm-hmm.
Quite stable, and you got a very good case as well. Now I don't have it here, but I like it a lot.
Yeah. So are you satisfied with this, or are you looking to add some other pedal? Now you're not using this part,
no,
but it's something you lack. It lacks something you don't get.
Actually, I'm thinking of buying a Kemper profile.
Okay, it's a,
because
then you don't have to have any of this.
No, exactly.
No pedals, no amp, no anything.
Because I love my Marshall EMP for that I use for recording and home. So it would be great to have that one on the road, and still have a backup at home. So I have the original at home and then the Kemper out. But
it's a bit more reliable and
yeah exactly. And but I've used this for a very long time now, and I love it as well. So maybe I will change during the show. So
we'll see.
Because I can. So,
okay.
So, yeah.
Well, I think that's all.
Yeah.
Do you have any special preferences when it comes to strings and picks?
Actually, yeah. I use this Dunlop. Now I torn off the sign. But this is not a standard pick.
Okay.
This is it's more point or more sharp. And
to play faster.
Yeah, exactly. And I think this thickness is 0.73 or something.
Okay.
I really like it. It's I tried quite many different, but this is what I stuck to. So, and the strings I use the normal 009.
Okay.
And
you tuned the standard pitch.
Yeah,
it's not
exactly.
It's not like us that's tuned down.
No, no. So we use.
That's cheating too.
Yeah, exactly. but it's nice. It makes another sound. And
I think it does.
Yeah, yeah. So, but we always use standard tuning. But I'm trying some drop D at least for acoustic and such. So maybe in some new Frontback tracks.
Okay.
We will see.
all tuned down.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. So
four half steps.
Yeah.
So, okay.
Yeah.
Well. Thank you very much, Axel.
Thank you for having me. And always fun to
my meet pleasure.
You. Yeah. Thank
be
you.
Be sure to
thank
check
you.
This band out.
Yeah. And Love Bomb as well.
It's not that good. Don't check it. And here we are with the main figure. Everyone else will disagree, maybe, but this is the front person in Frontback. So who's this?
This is Anlo, the front person in Frontback.
Yeah.
And lead singer and a rhythm guitar.
Mm-hmm. Also famous for being the best rock singer in Sweden.
Yeah.
Not just my opinion.
No, I won a competition last year.
Well deserved.
Thank
okay.
You.
So besides singing, like having the best voice in Sweden, you play the guitar as well.
Yeah, I play
rhythm
guitar.
So what do you think about, a lot of people think that it's really hard to combine singing and playing guitar.
I think it's easier to play guitar and sing together.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So have you ever been in a band where you haven't played guitar?
No, just a competition when I play.
Okay.
How
was that when the guitar wasn't there?
A little bit nervous.
Yeah?
I was supposed to play guitar. They didn't have place for another guitar.
Okay.
So I was forced to only sing.
They should have fired the other guitarists and have just two.
Brolle's guitar.
Brolle. He's not even plugged in, is he?
Yeah, of course he is. He's a real rocker.
So, okay. You seem to like SG-shaped guitars.
Yes, I love them.
What do you like about that shape?
Maybe most because they are very easy to handle.
It's not that heavy.
No,
it's true.
But I like the figure on it. And this I only bought because it's gold. the name is gold.
White and gold.
I like the gold stuff.
Mm-hmm. It's very nice and shiny. Yeah,
that's why I bought it.
Do you think? Sorry.
I got Gibson pickups.
Oh, it's Gibson pickups. Yeah. Because I know you usually are usually back in the day you used to play Gibson SGs
yeah,
as well.
Yeah, I've got Gibson SG. Mm-hmm. This is my.
How is this different to the SG?
I like to play the Gibson mm-hmm. more, mm-hmm. but I think
this
looks
better.
Yeah.
Shame on you, Gibson. Make very good looking guitars.
You need to do a custom made mm-hmm. guitar, Gibson.
Yes! Know who to call.
Yeah.
So, and this big chunk of Bixby trim, do you use it?
Only
or is
a
it just
bit.
In the way? It's just...
No, I use it a little.
Okay, you do.
In a few songs.
Everything goes out of tune.
Yeah, it does. But this is lockable. So this is I've changed as well.
Yeah, that's nice.
So this is a little bit better
yeah.
than the original.
It makes it a little bit easier to change
yeah.
strings. And everything. Oh, great. Okay, so the signal from the guitar is going to your wireless.
Yeah, I got a wireless system.
Mm-hmm. Line 6.
Six.
Mm-hmm. Some other bands using Line 6 as well.
Love them.
Mm-hmm.
Great.
And actually, this is a true story. We got the wireless packs because of Frontback.
Aww.
This is true. Because we thought you were so cool when you went around in the
yeah.
audience and everything. So
yeah,
that's a true story. True story.
Cool.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. I think it's easier to move when mm-hmm. I don't have mm-hmm. all the
yeah, you don't have to worry
shit.
About this. Yeah.
So, yeah, I like to move around a lot.
Okay. And then you go basically straight into the amp.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I only got a tuner.
Yeah, that's like a core
yeah,
pitch
core.
Black.
The easiest.
The one you can see in the dark.
Yeah.
So,
like
what kind of, when you set up the amp, you usually use the same amp or the same
as
kind
Axel,
of amp
yeah.
as Axel. What kind of sound are you looking for?
I
is there another guitarist that you're trying to sound like, or is it?
Not really, but I like the sound of Nirvana and stuff, so I don't.
Okay.
I wanted too much bass in the guitar.
Ah. Mm-hmm.
A little bit punk.
Okay. Yeah. Well, you have a bass player, so why should you have bass for the guitar?
Exactly.
It makes all the sense in the world.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So that's it. You have the same sound all the time? Do you?
Almost.
Okay.
Yeah.
So is there a clean one from time to time, or is it
no,
even
I
more
never,
distorted?
I never use clean.
That's rock and roll. No clean ever.
Only rock and roll.
Okay.
The easiest way possible is to play good music.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah. Okay. Do you do anything with the tone and volume knobs on the guitar, or is it everything on 10 all the time?
Always 10.
Always 10. She's so rock and roll.
Yeah, I'm so rock and roll.
Everything is 10 all the time.
Yeah.
Okay. Hmm? Anything else? How often do you change strings on your guitar? Be honest.
Maybe second month.
I change it maybe once every 2 years.
Yeah, I don't like to change strings. I like them when
if it ain't broken, why fix it?
I don't like new strings.
Oh, no.
But I feel forced sometimes to change them.
Okay, so what kind of picks do you use?
I like to use Dunlop. 073.
Is it better than other picks?
Yeah, I love them.
Mm.
But I have a Love Bomb pick home. I was supposed to take it with me today.
Makes everything sound better.
But I didn't want to lose it, so I kept it at home.
You're too kind. So when are the Frontback picks coming?
We have.
You have Frontback
yeah,
picks? I think I've seen those. You
yeah,
make like earrings and everything.
Earrings and bracelets and stuff.
We should do that.
Yeah, we don't use it on stage. Only to sell.
Okay. Psst. Last but not least, definitely not least. Who are you?
I'm Jonas. I play bass guitar in Frontback.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
So he does, and the way he plays, it's amazing. Okay, let's start talking about your gear and why not this amazing million string thing.
Yeah.
What is it?
Yeah. So basically, what I use live is a Fender Jazz Bass American Deluxe 5-string.
Mm-hmm.
For a simple reason, it's got a quite fat sound, but a
mm-hmm.
crunch to it also, and it, in weight wise, it's quite lightweight.
Okay. Yeah.
Compared to other basses I have.
You move around quite a bit, so
yeah. So
maybe
it's
that
important
helps.
For me that
yeah.
it's not too heavy to move
mm-hmm.
around.
Mm-hmm.
Also, it's not that expensive, so
relatively.
it I don't cry if I hit something with it.
Maybe it can take it as well.
Yeah, so
I don't know. Yeah.
This is my first choice when it comes to live shows, yeah.
Does it have like active electronics or anything?
Yeah, it's an active pickups, yeah.
How do you use them? Are they do you boost anything or?
I'm not a big fan of like the middle sound, so I increase the top and I increase the bottom.
Okay.
To make it fat, but also to that it enables you to hear also the string sound very well, and
okay,
also
yeah,
the
yeah.
tone of the of the actual note that I hit.
Yeah.
And also, it doesn't make the plunk sound.
No plunk sound.
I'm allergic.
What the hell? I used to play bass. That was the sound I was going for.
Yeah. I
it's a different. Have you played in other bands where there haven't been so many guitarists, or is your sound based to like interact with the guitars? Because you have two fat guitar sounds as well.
So my background is a bit similar to this, but I've also played in more progressive, more technical bands. So I've learned to make my way through guitar sounds.
Okay.
Also, I have some on my pedal board that enables the bass to come through the sounds.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you're using it's five strings, and how is it tuned? Is it regular five string tuning?
Regular five
low
string
B?
Tuning, low B. Yeah.
Yep.
Yep.
And you use the low B as well.
Yes, of course. Otherwise, I could have a four
string.
Yeah.
And you talked earlier. What other basses are you using?
So I have for studio work or for backup, I use a Music Man Stingray 5, a limited edition. So it's got a blue pearl and gold plated. But it's you don't even have to be good to be able to play that well.
So so this is a bit more work.
Yeah, you have to.
Because you notice when you play that you put your soul into it and you really.
Yeah, so I have to work a lot more with my fingers and also the pressure towards the fretboard, in comparison to the Music Man, where I almost doesn't have to touch the strings for it to make some sounds, or I can play wrong and it corrects me. So I really enjoy the Music Man, but more for studio work. On the new album, on the Heart of a Lion album, every song is played with the Music Man, actually.
Okay.
So no song is played with this one.
Yeah, by the way, check out Heart of a Lion, new album by Frontback. So what kind of strings are you using?
I use Ernie Ball, usually 55 on the...
Oh, really?
And 55,
really
125.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Just to make that fat sound sound fat.
And you never play with picks?
I always play with picks, yeah.
You always play with picks?
Yeah.
Sorry.
Wrong information.
I got that completely wrong.
Here it is.
Ah!
Yeah. So I don't have a preference on a brand or anything.
It seems quite thick.
Yeah, so I use a 1.5 millimeter guitar pick.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
But it has to be like a rough surface for the fingers to touch. Otherwise,
so you don't drop it.
Yeah.
Okay, that's nice.
So I think that's my main two bases here that I use.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, let's go to your pedal board. You're using. You're actually using pedals, and you actually you hear the sound of them when you play. It's actually used. It's not just in the background.
Yeah.
So why do you go into the?
So you the one thing we talked about it before, the pedal that makes the bass sound go through the guitars, otherwise it just or it cuts through the guitar sound, and this is actually this one, the EBS Multicom.
Mm-hmm. Swedish pedal.
So it's a compressor pedal, and honestly, I can't tell you what it does, but it's just magic. If you just compress it and gain it up a little bit, and it just cuts through everything, I would say.
Well, that probably helps with the five string as well.
I mean, I've used this for now 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
Hadn't done it before, and as soon as I got it, it blew my mind.
You've never turned it off since.
I've never heard my bass in the rehearsal.
Oh, really?
In the rehearsal before, and now I could actually hear the notes that I was playing. Mm-hmm. So, and I realized how wrong I was playing. Yeah.
There are several settings on it. Which mode do you use?
Yeah, so I use the tube sim mode.
Okay.
And I have the comp almost up to the maximum and gained it up a little bit.
Yep.
Because if I gain it up too much,
the, distorts the sound.
He will scream.
Oh, the sound guys hate scream, that. Yeah. Okay.
And then the second pedal I use more is the wah-wah pedal, and I use it in like maybe 40% of the songs.
Oh, really? That much? What kind of wah-wah is it?
It's a crybaby bass. Yeah.
Oh, crybaby bass. Yeah. Okay. Crybaby bass. That's hard to say. Too many B's.
Crybaby bass. Yeah. And then I have the Zoom digital pedal.
Yeah, the B3.
To be honest, I don't really use it that much. It's if I have a section in a song, if it calms down, I can use the area reverb. So I have three settings. I have the another EQ on it.
Mm-hmm. And then what do you use that for?
If I want to make the lower register even more enhanced.
Okay. Oh, yeah, yeah.
And then I have the arena reverb, and that's for like ballads, but Frontback doesn't have any, so it's just for my
just
playing
rock.
It's just for my playing around at home.
Okay. Yeah.
And then the Mark B setting is even more string sound, I would say.
Okay.
So if I have like a section where I start alone or something like that, I put this on, and then I use the wah-wah combined. Oh. Then it makes the audience really listen to the bass, because often like musicians or especially bassists, they hear the bass, but
the audience
music
doesn't know.
Enjoyers or the common enjoyers maybe don't actually
they don't understand why the band has a bass player. No,
exactly. They wondering what the hell is it, that dude doing there.
Okay.
He's just headbanging.
That's important. Too.
So
that's what it's because I heard you we were here for soundcheck, and I thought you had like a flanger or something when you did your intro, but that's the
wah-wah.
Bass and
yeah,
the
surprise,
wah-wah.
Maybe,
okay,
yeah.
Okay. Sounded great.
And okay. When it comes to like amplifiers and speakers, my whole music career I've used Hatke.
Okay, that's you have the one of your amps over here.
And I got one of the amps over there.
Let's go.
It's not my speaker, but the amp is mine. So it's a 300 watts. Hatke. It suits my style, I think.
How is it different to other amps?
I mean, I've tried like, because when you're out on the road, sometimes you borrow things, I've played like 12 or 15 other amps, and I always go home and think I got the best
you
one
got the
for
best.
Me, for me at least.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, I want the low register, but I still want the audience to hear the strings and the tones that I play. So, and this really reflects that, that target for me.
Is there another bass player that you're trying to emulate, or a bass sound with another band that you really like are going for?
Not really. No. I try to. I enjoy other bass players' sounds, even though it doesn't suit me or my
okay,
style.
Yeah, yeah.
But I think for me, I know what I like, and when I find it, or I have found it, I stick with it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And you don't change any settings on the amp, is set the same way all through the gig.
The amp
is nothing,
always set the same.
Yeah, no separate channels or
no.
anything.
No, it's always set the same, and if I want to change anything, I do it on my pedal board. Mm. So no one dares to touch that.
Or you'll kill them.
Yeah.
Is your sound super clean, or is it slightly distorted though?
No, it's super clean.
Okay.
It's like a studio sound, clean, clean sound, a lot of bass and a lot of string sound.
Oh yeah.
I like the fatness. But I also like the crunch, so to speak. It's hard to explain what noise I like.
Yeah, it really cuts through.
That's in all, basically it. Yeah.
And at the sound check, everyone was complaining. We can only hear the bass. Is that a common thing?
That's like a.
That's what you never heard. Like, hey, I can't hear myself.
No, today, unfortunately, I stand over there and I have the rig over here.
Oh, yeah, the rig
on
the other side. Yeah.
Usually, I'm the only one who are worried about this one. But now, okay. Today, Axel, unfortunately, he has to enjoy some bass sound.
Is that what you're playing? Yeah. I've never heard it before.
I never heard that song.
I didn't know the bass was even on.
Exactly.
Well.
And I try to... I don't know how much time we have, but my target is, since I started playing bass when I was, I think I started when I was 14 years old, I always thought that most bass players do it very dull, very boring. My target has always been like trying to show people that you can actually play the bass and you can actually do the things that the guitarists do and make the bass a fun instrument to both listen to and to play. Yeah. So that's always been in my mind and still.
And you succeed. I mean, when you go to a gig and you see this guy play, it's like it's all over the neck and it's not like you're playing the root note all the time. You're really doing melodic stuff as well.
I would be bored if I do that. Yeah. So
he's really good technically as well. He really knows how to play. I'm really impressed by it. It's true. So check it out. Frontback, new album, Heart of a Lion.
Yeah.
Where can you get it?
You can get it everywhere, I think. All the online shops and, of course, Spotify, YouTube. Mm-hmm. There's a video on YouTube. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so.
I will leave a link for that one.
Yeah.
And it's amazing. And check them out live if they're ever anywhere near your town. So you have to go. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Best band in the world. Yeah. Off the Love Bomb. Okay. Yeah. See you soon. Bye.